Let's continue our lessons with acronyms. Acronyms. These are forms of abbreviations. It is the first letter of a name that's used to form the acronym. It does make a new word, so a new word is formed, and this new word is pronounced. It is pronounced. So let's look at, I've got four examples for you. The first one is a popular music group called ABBA. That's how we say it in California, ABBA. And it stands, each letter represents the first letter of each name of the person, of the four people of the group. So we've got the A, the B, the B, the A. And when we put them together as an acronym and it's pronounced as a new word, that's the important part. It's pronounced as a new word. That means it's the acronym that's pronounced, ABBA. So now let's look at another example. You may have heard of laser. Laser, well, we know what a laser is, but laser is originally an acronym, meaning from light amplification by simulated emission of radiation. That's a lot to remember. So we've got the first letter of the five main words, and they form an acronym that's now become a word that's pronounced, laser. Okay, let's look at our third one. The third one is ASAP, ASAP. Now, some people will pronounce it also as the initialism of ASAP, but yet it's becoming much more common now to say ASAP, which is as soon as possible. The first letter of each of the four words makes ASAP. Now, ASAP has been written like this without punctuation, and it's been fine, even little letters. It tends to text real easy. Or if you want to be a little bit more bold and put it with capital letters, you can. ASAP, as soon as possible. Now, our last one that I want to look at with you is AWOL. AWOL. Now, this came from military terms, but it's become much more common now, even within jobs, when people are absent without leave, absent without, I know, without one word, and they take the W and the O, but it just makes the acronym easier to pronounce, AWOL. So absent without leave is AWOL. So these are examples of acronyms that are pronounced.